Ice Film Festival. We're at the Party Pavilion.
Hello, and thank you.
And it is hopping. As a matter of fact, everybody's been drinking.
It's so wild.
We are joined here with our friends Charles and Chris.
Charles Peterson and Chris Willembrecht, both filmmakers.
Doing?
Yes.
Thank you very much.
I'm
so honored to be on the show.
Thank you. Welcome to the Movie Guys with a guy and a gal.
That's right. Of course, we do the show, but we're also filmmakers, so we can talk shop with you guys. Now, do either of you have something that's in the festival this year?
This year I have a film called Schism.
Okay.
Wait, Schism? I've heard of that.
Yeah, the postcards are all over the film festival. I hope it's an Arizona short, and I know this is a big international film festival.
Yeah.
But I really want everybody to see a local film.
Where would you find Schism other than at the film festival?
At other film festivals.
Okay.
This is actually the world premiere of Schism.
This is the world premiere.
Oh, we got a scoop. We got a scoop. We didn't even know it.
This is very exciting.
This is scoop number two.
It's never been seen before outside of Charles's bedroom.
I hope you have a screening outside of your bedroom.
There's been some private screenings.
There's a lot of schisms going on in his bedroom.
You know, it's very close to Jism. Did you do that on purpose?
Yeah, because when people are going to see this movie, they're going to love it so much, they're going to schism all over themselves.
Oh, my gosh.
You know, earlier today, we saw this movie, and we were schisming all over ourselves.
Yeah.
Did you see it earlier today?
No, we didn't see this one. We saw a different one that Charles worked on. We saw Dust Jacket, where Charles did the special effects for.
Just so you guys
know, he also did the editing.
I did the editing
as well.
And the cinematography.
Yeah. Now, Dust Jacket, this is the second year that it's actually been at the festival, correct? It was in competition before, now it's just
screened. No, it wasn't in competition last year.
Us.
It was in the homegrown showcase in the Phoenix Film Festival side.
Right.
This year it's in the horror sci-fi.
It's in the horror sci-fi.
That's brilliant marketing on your part.
You know what? I told the director, Ken Miller, don't submit it. It's already been in there. They're never going to accept it. And he proved me wrong for once.
Yeah.
Good for you. Yes. You take and you work so hard on something, you want to get as much mileage out of it as you can.
Now, enough about that film by that guy who isn't here. Let's talk about some of the stuff that you guys have done. Give us the log line for Schism. What's it about?
Schism's about a guy who is going through relationship issues with his girlfriend and his father, and he ends up getting in a car accident.
Oh.
And once, it's a movie in split screen, so one side of the film, he's in a coma, and on the other side, it's like he walked away from the accident.
Gotcha.
That's really clever.
A divergent tale of sorts.
That it's life and death in split screen.
And it's about second chances.
Okay, very good. Now, Chris over here, talk to us about you. You're a producer as well.
Well, I produce a lot of films. I've known Charles and for a long time. He's actually a big influence on my work.
I'm sorry.
And no, that's really great.
I just met Charles, and he's a big influence on my work.
Do you have any films that rhyme with cursory words of some kind or vulgar words?
No, but I do have a premiere coming up on May 20th at Film Bar in Phoenix, Arizona, called Children of the Dust. I'm going to plug that shit. Yes,
absolutely.
That's the way to do it. I was hoping you had a film named something like, I don't know, Spism or something.
No. No. But I do have a film called Reality
Spemin
coming out as well.
Reality,
soon.
Yep.
Okay. Feature films or short films?
Short films.
Okay. Have either of you worked on any features yet, or shorts mainly your game?
I have worked on a movie, and I'm not going to say the movie's title because I'm really embarrassed by it.
But those are the best ones to mention, my friend.
But wait, it was it featured Corbin Burnson from...
I love it.
Major
League. So you'll be able to find it.
Oh, my gosh. That is fantastic. Yeah. Did you say Corbin Burnson from Major League as opposed to L.A. Law?
Or Kiss Kiss Bang Bang, right?
Fuck L.A. Law.
If you want to give the best, say Kiss Kiss Bang Bang, but it's funny that you'd pick Major League as
opposed
to...
Listen, he was a real joy to work with. Unfortunately, the producer wanted to be the lead actor, so you know how that goes.
He did chew out the producer, though.
He did, yes.
Which is a very interesting story for another time.
I have heard from friends of mine that have worked with him that seriously, this is actually on the management side, that he has the policy of he will accept anything that pays.
No.
He absolutely will.
Well, maybe that's what it was, but the script was really good.
Yeah. Was it?
The script was really good.
Hey, was a script worth getting naked for?
Yes.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, there you go. You get naked for material. But
that's what I learned from Charles.
Yes.
As he's telling me, do you want to get naked for material?
Hold on, let me say it.
What isn't worth getting naked for?
You don't get naked for the person, you get naked for the material.
Which person would you be getting naked for if you are getting naked? Well, if it depends on the sex scene.
It depends on the sex scene.
If it was a terrible script, but I still got naked with Angelina Jolie, I love you, honey. I'm still wearing my ring. However, if I had to get naked with Angelina, I would do that.
Can I direct you in that film?
Yeah.
Can I be the director?
Exactly. You want to be right there lighting it.
Yeah.
Fantastic. So you've got one coming up. Do you have anything coming up? What is your next one coming up?
I actually did two short films. I'm still on the short film craze. I love doing shorts.
Gotcha.
One's called Homecoming, starring Patrick Adam, who was in Schism, and Elias Castillo. And the second one was Three Cars with Mario Guzman, Carrie Fee, and Robin Egan.
That is fantastic.
Wait, Mario Guzman. Why do I know that name?
He's a local actor. He's really good.
He's been in stuff. You've seen him.
Yeah, I've seen him before.
Yeah. Also, and I want to touch on it real quick before we let you guys go. Now, you had a film that got you in a lot of trouble.
Yes.
Is this correct, Charles? Why don't you give us a brief synopsis and tell us what happened?
The film was called Sex and Violence. It starred, again, Patrick Adam and Carrie Fee. It's about a movie about a married couple who can only have sex after seeing violent images, going to crime scenes. And Patrick's character says, hey, I want to make love to you. I want to make true love to you. And the story develops there. But we took it to another Arizona film festival called Cave Creek Film Festival. They no longer run it because of this incident, but it got banned there.
And, congratulations.
And Suzanne Johnson, who's running the film festival, fought for the movie. I got to tell this quick story, and I'm not putting anyone down. She fought for the movie. One of the directors was the director who's judging the film, who fought for the film, was the president of the Sedona Film Festival.
Oh.
And he said, submit it to my film festival. We won't have a problem. The next thing I know, I get a rejection letter. That's horrible. Thank you.
Well, you get sexy for film festivals.
Yeah.
Too sexy for film festivals. You want to take us out, Karen?
I just want to say it's been really great getting to be best friends with Charles and his friend Chris.
Yeah.
Because we met them a long time ago when we arrived yesterday.
It feels like it was 700 or 800 hours.
Yeah, in a dark corner. Yeah. We all met together.
This is true. It was at night. We were taking pictures. It's a story for another time.
I'm telling you, every time you get around these guys, it turns into something dark at night, taking pictures, clothing comes off.
Naked. Right. I love naked bodies.
And then we all get banned.
Yeah.
So that's what goes on here at the Phoenix Film Festival. Good times, very wholesome entertainment.
Right.
You meet good people who don't drink all the beer at the party. Thank you. And just karaoke. So thank you, everybody. You guys are great.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks for having us.
Where can we find you online? Do you have a website or anything?
Yes, coolwavepictures.com. That's coolwavepictures.com.
All right. Is that where we can find you, Chris?
Coolwavepictures.com.
All right, coolwavepictures.com.
So remember both of those sites.
Yes.
Remember both of them.
Write both of them down.
Yes.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks a lot. Bye.